Hi, my name is Dr. Shaw for Liz Lam, and I've been meaning to make these videos for quite a long time, and I never got around to it. And the reason for making these videos is because people always ask me about how to get into the world of data. So I thought I'd make a few videos around how to get into the world of data, how to progress, and how to sort of establish a career in that. Whether you're interested in sort of data analytics, data science, business intelligence, reporting and visualization, I'm going to sort of cover all of that. So this is sort of my intro video. Like I said, I've been meaning to make this for a very long time, and I thought to myself, you know what, 2020 is almost going to be over. I should do something before it is over. So I thought, right, okay, I'll make a start. So this is my, like I said, my first video. I've been in the data space for about 20 years. My background is actually in psychology. So I have a PhD in psychology. And what I specialized in was building a behavioral model, so predictive models on how humans behave. And my PhD was based on trying to predict why children have accidents. So what I thought is, I've been in this space for, like I said, 20 years. I've worked in government, in NHS, private sector, and then I've worked in agencies as well for the last few years, and also have started my own analytics consultancy. I keep getting asked around how to get into the world of data, or how to progress, how to sort of manage teams and stuff. So I thought I'd talk a bit about that area. So in this video, what I'm really going to talk about is really the three areas that if you want to get into data that you should be looking towards. And especially for graduates or people who are new to the area, they're sort of thinking, well, I want to get into data, but what area do I get into? So I'm just going to bucket these into three areas. And like I said, people may use different bucketing or different areas, but these are the sort of three general areas that I've observed that data sort of fits into. So the first area is really business intelligence or reporting and visualization. And this is historically where data has really been used to report on business performance. Okay, so the idea being that you sort of get daily, weekly, even hourly reports around how a business performs. And this type of data work is based on a very structured data in data warehouses. So typically you'd have a business intelligence tool like Business Objects, Tableau, Power BI, that will plug into a data warehouse or a data mart and provide very structured reports. And the idea is that you can automate these reports. So you can run them on a regular basis, as I said, between hourly, daily, weekly, monthly, whatever you want to, whatever frequency you want to do. And to get into that space, you need to have a good understanding of how databases work, a good understanding of how data structures, and a good knowledge of a reporting tool. So whether it's good old-fashioned Business Objects, or whether the more modern tools like Power BI or Tableau or even Qlik, you need to have proficiency in those. You need to be very good at SQL. That really helps when you're trying to build those reports, especially because a lot of those data warehouses are based on either an Oracle data warehouse or a Microsoft data warehouse. So they use SQL, SQL, Structured Query Language, whichever term you prefer to use. So that's the first area. The second area that people want to get into, and I think this is the area that most people think about when they think about getting into data, is data analytics. And data analytics is literally, the way I see it, is to use data to answer business questions. So the business asks you a question, you analyze the data to answer that question. That essentially is how I see data analytics. So, the business may ask you a question such as, were sales higher this year compared to last year? And you just run a simple query and you provide that one-off answer. And you might provide some insight. So you might say, look, sales are higher this year compared to last year, but actually we had more stores. So therefore, if you do a like-for-like store, like-for-like analysis, we probably weren't up. But because we've had more stores, we've had more sales. So you provide a bit of context, a bit of domain knowledge, and some insights. And within data analytics, you would have people who are very technical, who would run models, run analysis, query data. And then you may have people who are very business-oriented, very insight-driven, who prefer to provide more insight, so they don't really need to be so technical. And the kind of skills you need here is, a lot of the time you might be given the data, so it's not necessarily important to know SQL to be able to extract the data. But again, if you knew SQL, that'd be really good, because then you can extract your own data. But like I said, typically in these fields, you might be given an extract of data, a data dump, as they call it. So you need a tool to analyze it. The traditional tools have been things like SPSS and SAS, but more modern tools are like R and Python. People are using them more, and they also fit into the world of data science. science, which I'll talk about in a bit. And then obviously you need to know Excel. If you're going to get into data analysis or data analytics, you have to be very good at Excel. If you can't use Excel, then you'll find you'll struggle. You know, no matter what people say nowadays, Excel is still one of the most dominant tools used in data analysis. And there's a lot you can do in that, you'll see. People also use things like Tableau and Power BI in data analysis. You can do quite a bit in those tools now. But I normally find that, you know, you need to use an actual querying, data querying tool like R, Python, SAS, SPSS. So that's data analytics. And like I said, it's specifically to answer business questions. The business will have a whole variety of questions. They want to know, you know, in COVID, for example, what's the impact of COVID has been. You've got to try and now articulate that into a data analysis. And then the final area is what I call data science, or what is called data science, and I bucket that. And what I see that difference between data analytics and data science is that, whereas in data analytics you're trying to answer business questions, in data science you're trying to solve a problem. Okay, so the problem might be, how do we grow sales, right? So so you're looking at the data, wondering how can we grow sales. So one of the ways might be that you decide that you do a basket analysis so that you can provide recommendations to people when they buy certain products, or you may decide that you create an upsell or a cross-sell model. So there's lots of things that you can do in terms of solving problems, and that's where data science comes in. With data science, sometimes the hard bit, or the bit, I guess, that relates to science, is that you have to have a hypothesis, that you're starting off with a point of view. You're saying, right, okay, the reason we want to increase sales is because we're not as good as our competitors, or we think we can sell more, or we think there's an opportunity. So you're trying to answer, you know, test a hypothesis, and then you go into the data to see if it's possible to solve that problem or answer that problem. Okay, so they're sort of the three areas. In data science, the type of tools that you need are potentially like R and Python. They're the pretty dominant ones. SQL is good to have as well. I mean, you'll come across databases all the time. People talk about big data technologies like Hadoop, Spark, those kind of stuff, MongoDB, data lakes. So, you know, things like AWS and Microsoft Azure, blob storage, you know, you still need to understand about data lakes. Also, you always need to understand about databases. You need to have that kind of knowledge. And once you have that kind of knowledge, then you can sort of start operating in the data science space. So that's really the three areas, like I said, that I believe if you want to get into the world of data, pick an area. And, you know, some people do sort of sift across all three, but generally you'll find that you will gravitate towards one, and you'll prefer that and become also good at it. So that's really my intro video. I would love to hear your comments. So if you have any comments about what I've just said, or if you want to ask me any questions, please write it in the comments below. And please obviously like my video, and please do subscribe to my channel. Thank you very much. I'll try and do more videos. Thank you.